After recently visiting the city of New Orleans in Louisiana and taking in all the culture and history of the state, it got me thinking about the unique position of the area. Louisiana is the only area in the United States, other than a small region along the border of Quebec, where French is widely spoken as a native language, with an estimated 6 to 10% of Louisiana's population speaking French, or French Creole as a first language. The number of French speakers in the state has been on the decline in recent years following the federal government's program of forcing rural inhabitants of Louisiana to learn and speak English since the early 1900s. But having such a large bilingual population is virtually unheard of in other areas of the country other than Spanish-speaking populations. The French impact on the region is also quite evident in architecture, cuisine, culture, and vocabulary. But how did this come to be? The history of the Franco-descended peoples of Louisiana actually begins in Canada, believe it or not, in the province of Quebec and the maritime areas of Canada's eastern coast, including New Brunswick, Nova Scotia, and Prince Edward Island. Back in the late 1700s, all of this area was a part of France's territory known as New France, and the maritime provinces were collectively known as Acadia. The area was very sparsely populated for the time when compared to nearby British North America, with only a few tens of thousands of French settlers living in the entire area. These settlers came from mostly the west coast of France, including the regions of Normandy and Brittany. From 1754 to 1763, France and Britain fought for colonial dominance over basically the entire planet, in a conflict known as the Seven Years' War. And Britain ended up victorious in the North American theater of the war, better known to most people in North America as the French and Indian War. After French military presence collapsed in North America, the British decided to keep Quebec a French area, yet expelled nearly all of the French Acadians from the region of Acadia to make room for more English settlers. And today, the majority of the maritime provinces are of Anglo origin, while Quebec is predominantly of French origin. The Acadians were scattered throughout the continent, with many returning to France, while others went to the modern-day territories of the United States, but especially Louisiana, which actually was recently ceded to the Spanish Empire by France. The Acadians that made their new life in Louisiana adapted to the swamps and wetlands of their new home, and were soon accompanied by new settlers from Spain and France, who assimilated into the emerging culture of the region, now known as Acadiana, in modern-day southern Louisiana. This group slowly created their own ethnic identity, and the name Acadian slowly morphed into Cajun, creating the modern ethnicity we see today. The average genetic makeup of the modern Cajun is overwhelmingly European in origin, coming from France, Spain, Portugal, and Great Britain. However, many Cajuns do have a small amount of African or Native Amerindian admixture. They speak a dialect of French called Cajun, which is still mutually intelligible with French spoken in metropolitan France and is not quite divergent enough to be classified as a Creole language. The number of Cajun Americans is officially at 120,000 people, although this is probably a severe underestimation since many Cajuns may choose to identify as French or American under the U.S. Census Bureau. The real number is most likely closer to around 1 million people, placing them at over 15% of Louisiana's population, which, when combined with those that identify as ethnically French, makes them the largest single ethnic group in the state. There is a large diaspora of Cajuns in the rest of the country, with the neighboring state of Texas having around 100,000 Cajuns. After Hurricane Katrina in 2005, the city of New Orleans was virtually destroyed, with over 80% of the city being flooded under an average of 20 feet of water. This unprecedented destruction of an American city saw hundreds of thousands of refugees from Louisiana heading to other states, and many Cajuns and Creoles headed to cities such as Dallas and Houston. The history of the Louisiana Creole people is a bit different from that of the Cajuns. Creole people are a relatively old group that began to form in southern Louisiana in the late 1700s when French settlers began mixing with the African slaves in the region, creating a mixed-race population. This originally small group of mixed-race people were seen as free people of color, and even further intermixing with Native Americans also commenced. After Louisiana was ceded to Spain, many Spanish and other European settlers also intermarried with the Creoles. The genetic makeup of Louisiana Creole people varies greatly because of the geographic spread, but on average, they're 56.2% African, 34.7% European, 6.7% Native American, 2.2% Middle Eastern, most likely from Canarian immigrants known as Isleños, and 0.2% East or Southeast Asian, most likely from early Filipino immigration to Spanish Louisiana. This gives Creoles a gene pool that is majority African, as could be expected, but they have a much higher percentage of ancestry from Europe and Native Americans when compared to other Black Americans, who only have around 21% European and 1% Native American DNA, respectively. The Louisiana Creole may or may not identify with other Black Americans, depending on their phenotype, culture, or where they live, but nearly all Creole people check off African American on the U.S. Census Bureau rather than mixed race or some other race. Of course, self-identification is subjective, and many Louisiana Creole are actually majority European, a few majority Amerindian, and a few overwhelmingly African. But the average gives a very interesting picture for the average Creole indeed. Their culture is a blend of traditions from metropolitan France, Louisiana Cajuns, Black Americans, West African Niger-Congo peoples, and a small amount of the Native Amerindians that originally populated southern Louisiana. Their language, which is also called Louisiana Creole, is actually a Creole language, unlike Cajun, which is seen as a dialect, because the Creole language is divergent enough from standard French that the two languages are mutually unintelligible, meaning someone who spoke only French would not be able to understand a Louisiana Creole speaker. Their language has influences from many languages, including English, Spanish, various Native African and Amerindian languages, and is most akin to Haitian Creole or other French Creole languages from the Caribbean. There are no official records or estimates on the number of Louisiana Creole people living in the United States today, and very few estimates from third-party sources. But by extrapolating data on the number of Louisiana Creole speakers and the number of freed blacks in Louisiana before the Civil War, I arrived at a number of about 220,000 ethnic Louisiana Creole people in the entirety of the United States, of which perhaps 190,000, or about 86% of which, still reside in the state of Louisiana, with the majority of the rest living in surrounding states, especially Texas, as well as having a small community in Los Angeles, California, believe it or not. This means that around 4% of Louisiana's population is Louisiana Creole, making them the third largest racial group in the state after white and black Americans. The majority of Louisiana Creole are Roman Catholic, like their paternal French ancestors, but there's a growing Protestant minority and an even smaller minority that still practices animistic and shamanistic religions such as voodoo, which is actually native to West African nations such as Benin and Togo. But still, this is an extremely small percentage, probably no more than 1% of people. Louisiana Creole have been intermixing with other Black American groups for a long time, but are similar to the Gullah, also known as the Geechee people of the Southeast Coast, who are of African descent, yet distinct from the larger Black American ethnic group. The difference being, the Gullah are descended from Afro-Caribbeans from the Bahamas, with roots in Central Africa. Many people of all races like to pretend that all Americans of African descent are the exact same, but this is very far from the truth, just like how all white or Asian Americans aren't the same, and assuming they are is just ignorant. Cajun and Louisiana Creole are often used interchangeably to mean the same thing by Americans from outside Louisiana, and Cajun are often thought of as mixed race, but the Cajuns are actually the ones of European descent, while the Creoles are multiracial, and they speak rather different languages, and although very similar, their cultures are also unique. Cajun and Creole culture can certainly be classified under the larger umbrella category of Franco-Louisiana culture, however, since they both stem largely from French colonists in North America. Because of the Cajun and Creole people of Louisiana, French impact and culture is abound in southern Louisiana, a quirky outlier among the rest of the southern states, which have historically been dominated by Anglo-Protestant culture. The Cajuns and Louisiana Creole have many similarities between culture, language, and heritage, but are two very distinct ethnic groups, and one thing for certain is that both groups take a lot of pride in their culture which has been the foundation for Louisiana for almost 4 centuries. Living here in the Dallas-Fort Worth area, I've actually met quite a few Cajun and Creole people from Louisiana, especially after Hurricane Katrina, and I did interview a few of them to get the right perspective for this video. So go ahead and let me know your thoughts on the Cajuns and Louisiana Creole in the comments down below. Thanks for watching, everyone. This has been Mason, and I'll see you next time.